The Luma key effect within Final Cut Pro can be an awesome tool to utilize in the right situations. Let me show you one right here.
We have this logo, and we want to make it transparent. But we can't use a chroma key because there's no color we can key out. This is when the Luma key comes in handy.
Let's hide the white.
First, we'll place our background clip in the timeline. Next, we'll position our playhead where we want to add our foreground clip. Then, in the browser, we'll choose the clip, press X to select the full duration, and press Q to connect it to the primary storyline. And we'll trim these clips so that they have the same duration. Now let's apply the Luma key. Select the foreground clip. Then, navigate to the right and click on the Effects button. Then we'll locate the Luma keyer effect. We'll click on All, then search keyer. Oh, we found it! Now drag the effect to the foreground clip. In the viewer, we can see the default Luma key applied to our subject. Clearly, we need to make some changes. Navigate to the inspector on the top right. If the inspector is not showing, click on this icon. And click on the video icon. By default, the Luma keyer will automatically remove the dark values in our logo. But we want the white removed, so we'll click on Invert. Now we see the logo is not quite placed correctly, so we'll make some changes in our transform effect.
It looks pretty good so far, but let's keep going.
Next, let's use the controls to improve our key. At the top, we can slide these Luma level controls to adjust the light and dark values on our subject. To modify the softness of the edges, we can adjust the Luma roll-off control. The lower the value, the softer the edge will be. These view options will help us while editing. Composite is the default view, showing the final composited image. Matte shows an alpha channel of the key, which is a black and white representation of the keyed and unkeyed areas. White represents the areas on the foreground that will be showing. The black represents completely transparent, and gray represents areas of partial transparency. And original shows no effect at all. To leave the text or graphics unchanged, we can choose Preserve RGB. But in this case, it doesn't give a good result, so we'll uncheck it. To reduce the opacity of the keyed effect, adjust the mix control. Stay tuned for our next video, where we'll cover the advanced Luma key controls.
If you want to be an awesome Final Cut editor, all you gotta do is like and share.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.